First problem already solved. Second problem also solved. In the second problem, purchase of material, direct wages, opening stock, closing stock. These two are to be adjusted at their own heads. I think it is solved one. Example number three. The following information has been obtained from the records of Mathosri Limited for the period from June 1st, 2006 to June 30th, 2006. Okay, this is the cost sheet for the month of June. It is related with only one month. So, you have to take the opening stock of raw material, add purchases during the year. Add opening stock of the month. First, you take the opening stock of the month, add purchases during the month, then deduct the closing stock of raw material at the end of the month. Okay. Then secondly, take wages paid, add outstanding. Opening stock, add outstanding, you will get the wages. Then if there is a direct expense, you take, otherwise take the total prime cost. Then factory overhead, add work in progress opening less closing work in progress, you will get the factory overhead. Then next is, you take the administrative overhead. After administration overhead, you will get the cost of production. To that, you add opening finished stock less closing finished stock. Then add selling and distribution expense, you will get the cost of sale. Then you leave one line and take the sale. Difference between sale and cost is called as profit. Like this, you solve this problem. Then fourth problem, it is already solved on 40 paisa. I think it is solved one. Then the question number 5. In the question number 5, material is direct material, 56,000. Direct material 56,000. Then direct wages 60,000. If there are direct expense, you take and take the total, that is prime cost. Then add factory overheads. In the factory overhead, you take the indirect wages. Other direct expenses here. Direct material, direct wage, direct expense, prime cost. Then indirect wage, factory rent, indirect material. Indirect material, then depreciation on plant, then okay, these are the factory overheads. I will explain one by one. Indirect wage, factory, other direct expense, direct, factory rent, factory overhead, office rent, office and administration, indirect material, factory overhead, depreciation on plant, factory, office furniture, office and administration. Then the general expense of factory, general expenses, factory, factory overhead, office, office overhead, selling and sales, selling and distribution. The general expense is misplaced, you take it the second part. General expense you take in the second part and solve the problem. Managing director remuneration, administration, traveling expense, sales, office salary, office and administration, carriage outward, selling and distribution, advertisement, selling and distribution, sales, last item, and take the difference, profit or loss. Then sixth problem, example number six, opening stock of material, add purchase, less closing stock, add carriage inward, material consumed. Direct wage, direct prime cost, wages indirect, factory overhead, other direct charges comes under the prime cost, rent and rates, factory goes to factory overhead, office goes to office overhead, then indirect material, factory, depreciation, plant, factory, office, office overhead. Salary, salary goes to office, office and administration. Salesman goes to selling and distribution expense, head. Other office expense, office and administration. Other factory, factory overhead. Other selling, selling and distribution. Traveling expense, selling and distribution. Carriage outward, selling and distribution. Advance income tax paid. Advance income tax paid is related with income, not related with cost. Therefore, it is non-cost item. Sales, last item. And write it the last and take the difference, profit or loss. Advertisement, selling and distribution. Okay. Then seventh example, I think this type of problem I already solved. I will not go for explaining it. It is already solved one. Then example number eight is also solved. Example number eight, I have solved it. If I have solved, once again I explain. These three, opening. Opening is added, closing is deducted. Raw material in the raw material, work in progress, factory overhead, finished goods, cost of production. Raw material purchase, material, carriage on purchase, material, direct wage, direct expense, prime cost. These are the prime cost item. Raw material return. Raw material return, it is deducted in the material. Factory expense, factory, administration expense, administration, income tax is based on profit or income. So it is non-cost item. Dividend is a part of profit. It is non-cost item. These two items will not come under the cost sheet. Selling expense, selling and distribution. Sale, last item. To write this and ascertain the profit or loss. Next, following particulars are extracted from the cost books of Bahubali. I think it is solved one. I have solved this problem already. You see the example number 10. Raw material used in manufacture is called as direct material. Raw material used in primary packing. Primary packing is also direct. Remember this. Raw material used in manufacture means main raw material. And primary packing is also related with that. These two are related to direct material. Material used in selling goes to selling and distribution expense. Remember this. Material used in selling in the product goes to selling and distribution overhead. Material used in factory, factory overhead. Material used in office, office overhead. I'll give you the example. Direct material means, for example, you are to manufacture the soap. Produce your soap, you require certain materials. That is material used in manufacture. And to pack that soap, primary packing is also with that product. It is direct. Material used in selling the product means boxes. Boxes are required to distribute. Containers. Materials. Material used in factory means it may be lubricant, it may be diesel, petrol, grease, etc. Material used in office means pen, pencil, paper, stationery, etc. Okay. Labor required in producing, it is direct labor. Labor required in factory supervision, indirect labor, it is factory overhead. Indirect expense, factory overhead. Administration expense, administration. Depreciation of office building, office and administration. Depreciation on factory building, factory overhead. Selling expense, selling and distribution. Freight on material purchase, it is added to material, direct material. You add this to the direct material. Advertising goes to selling and distribution. And you calculate profit based on that. You take the total cost into 20 divided by 80. You will get the profit. Next, example number 11. I think it is solved one. Opening stock are there, closing stocks are there. The opening is added, closing is deducted, raw material purchase added. Carriage inward, add. Wages, direct wages. Factory manager salary, factory power, factory expenses. Selling and distribution, selling and distribution. Depreciation. Depreciation you take under the head factory. Nothing is mentioned. Then accountant salary, office and administration. General expense, office and administration. Income tax, non-cost item, will not come. Payment of sales tax, it is also not related to cost after sales. Then dividend. Dividend is not a cost item. It is part of profit. Okay. Sales, last item. Goodwill written off, non-cost item. So you will not consider these items. Okay, you solve this problem. Then example number 12. Opening stock add, closing stock less. Raw material in the raw material, finished goods in the cost of production, work in progress in the factory overhead. Raw material purchase, direct wages, material return. This problem answers are wrong, I think. Someone already clarified this problem and the answers may be wrong. So, I'll see which problem, I don't know. You solve according to the given direction. Raw material, added in the raw material, direct wage, second item. Purchase return, you deduct in the material. Work expense, factory overhead. Administrative expense, administration overhead. Sale of factory scrap is to be deducted in the factory overhead. This is to be deducted in the factory overhead. You deduct this amount in the factory overhead. Selling and distribution expense. Sales, last item. You take the items as explained and solve the problem. Example number 13. I think it is solved one. I solved this problem. Example number 14. Opening stock, closing stock. Okay. It is also easy one. Add opening, less closing, material, finished stock in the cost of production, raw material, work in progress, factory overhead, purchase of raw material, carriage inward, purchase expense, wages, second item, work manager salary, factory, employee salary, factory, factory rent, factory, power expense, factory, production expense, factory, general expense, administration. Sales, last item. Income tax, non-cost item. Dividend, non-cost item. Debenture interest, non-cost item. Selling expense, selling and distribution. These three are the non-cost items. Income tax, dividend and debenture interest are not related to cost. So you don't consider these three items. Next example number 15. The following particulars, from the following particulars, prepare a statement of cost. Raw material, opening, add purchase, less closing stock of raw material. Then productive wage means direct wage. Direct wage, finished stock is there, opening. Work expense means factory overhead, administrative overhead, selling expense, selling and distribution, sales, last item. On the basis of this, you prepare the cost sheet. You prepare the cost sheet and calculate the given percentage. Okay. How to calculate the percentage? Factory overhead percentage is equal to factory overhead divided by direct labor into 100. And administration overhead percentage is equal to administration overhead divided by factory cost into 100. These are the two important equations we use in the cost, and these two equations are helpful for estimation of the cost in future. Yesterday I solved one problem based on this. Okay, you calculate the 2%. One is factory overhead percentage, another is administrative overhead percentage. That is already calculated in the note. Next, example number 16. This is the problem same as already solved one. Then example number 17. Example number 17. Opening stock of raw material, opening work in progress, raw material is to be adjusted in raw material, direct wage, carriage inward is purchase expense, indirect material is a factory overhead, counting house salary is related with office, factory rent is related to factory overhead, office rent is related with administration overhead, printing and stationery, office and administration, depreciation on factory building, factory overhead, office salary related with office, raw material closing, work in progress closing are to be deducted in the respective head. Then indirect factory wage, factory overhead, drawing office salary, factory overhead, finished goods adjusted in the cost of production, sales 20% profit on cost. Okay, you see here, this is the 20% on cost of sale. So first you calculate the prime cost, second factory cost, third cost of production, then cost of goods sold, then cost of sale. Whenever you are having the cost of sale amount and profit is based on the cost of sale, then you calculate profit percent directly on the cost. That means cost of sale into 20 divided by 100. 100 divided by 100. At the numerator, 20. Denominator, 100. 100 is to be taken only when given base is given in the problem. The base is given in the problem, you have to take 100. Okay, divided by 100, 20 divided by 100, remember this point. Directly calculate 20% on the cost of sale and add to the cost of sale, you will get this sale. Profit is 20% on cost of sale, therefore cost of sale will be in the cost sheet. You take that amount and make the 20%, you will get profit. And the company produced 40,000 units during the year. And you divide by 40,000 to assert in the per unit up to the stage of cost of production. Then 5,000 units are closing stock units. Closing finished stock is 5,000. You deduct the 5,000, you will get 35,000 as the close units sold. On the basis of that, you proceed. Next part. Example number 18. Following cost sheet information related to commodity for the half year ending 31st December 2000. I think it is solved one. I already solved this problem. I know it. Question number 19. From the details given below, from the books of Sagaru, this is also solved one. This problem already solved. And next is Gen Manufacturing Company for the year in 2000. The accounts of Gen Manufacturing Company for the year ending 31st March 2000 show the following. They are given the following items. I will explain. Factory salary goes to factory. Carriage outward goes to selling and distribution. Bad debt goes to selling and distribution. Rent and rates, factory. Rent and rates goes to office. Material purchase, material. Traveling expense, selling and distribution. Traveler salary, selling and distribution. Director fee, administration. Manager salary. You take 3/4 to the factory overhead, 1/4 to the office and administration. General expense, office and administration, carriage on purchase added to material. It is carriage means purchase expense. Repair to machine, factory overhead. Sales, last item. Stock of material, opening, closing. Opening, closing is here. Add and less in the material. Productive wage, direct wage. Depreciation on machine, factory. Depreciation on furniture, office. General expense, office. Income tax, not related to cost. Dividend, not related to cost. Now see the example number 21. Purchase of material, material. Indirect labor, factory. Direct labor, freight on raw material, purchase expense. Other factory overhead, sale unit, 15,000, sales is given. So, it is the last item. Indirect material, factory. Then position, opening is to be added, closing is to be deducted. Raw material in the raw material, work in progress in the work in factory overhead. And finished stock, you have to adjust in the cost of production. Units are given. Finished stock, units are given. This is to be valued on the basis of cost of production per unit. I have solved 3-4 problems based on this. You take units, multiply by the cost of production per unit. How many units produced? During the year, 16,000 units produced. From the raw material stage to cost of production, you divide by 16,000. You will get the cost per unit. Then after, you adjust the finished stock. Okay. Then example number 22. In the example number 22, I will explain the items one by one. Drawing office, factory, counting office, office administration, carriage and cartage outward. It is selling and distribution. Carriage and cartage, purchase, purchase expense. Bad debt, selling and distribution. Repairs to plant, factory overhead. Rent and insurance, factory goes to factory, office goes to office. Sales, last item. Stock of material adjusted in the material. Purchase of material, first item. Traveling expense, selling and distribution. Salary and allowance to salesman, selling and distribution. Direct wage in the prime cost. Depreciation, plant is related with factory, furniture is related with office. Director fee, office and administration. Water and gas, factory goes to factory, office goes to administration. Manager salary, 3/4 factory, 1/4 office. General expense, office and administration. Income tax, dividend, these two are non-cost items. Okay, then example number 23. In the example number 23, materials, stock of material, opening stock, add purchase, less closing stock. Last item, counting of salary, office and administration, bad debt, selling and distribution, salesman commission, selling and distribution, depreciation of office furniture, office and administration, direct wage, direct labor, director fee, administration, sale, last item, general manager, administration, work manager, factory, depreciation and repairs to plant, factory, direct expense comes under the prime cost, gas and water, office, rent and insurance, office. It is directly explained. Then gas and water off factory goes to factory. Drawing office salary, factory. Rent and insurance, factory goes to factory. General expense, 2/3 factory, 1/3 office. Carriage outward, selling. Power cost, factory. Advertisement, selling and distribution. Postage, office and administration. Okay. Up to 20, one more problem I'll explain within 1 minute. Opening stock, purchase, closing stock, adjusted, carriage inward, added to material. Direct expense comes under the direct wage. Direct wage, prime cost. Indirect wage, factory. Rent and rates, office, rent and rates, factory, indirect material, factory, depreciation plant, factory, depreciation office, office and administration, sales, last item, salary, selling and sales distribution, other factory expense. After this, I'll continue after 10 minutes break. I'll take 10 minute break and continue the income tax period. I'll give you 10 minute break and continue the income tax period. So only 1 minute time is there. I'm explaining this problem. After this, I'll give you 10 minute break and rejoin at 11:30.